I always give away too much. It's like I've got no sense of touch.
Hey, Life for Tribe. Happy Sunday. I don't think y'all can see all these groceries that I have in front of me, but we about to make some collard green gumbo, I think they call it. I don't know. It's gumbo, but collard green. So we got our greens, and yes, I do cheat and buy the greens already in the bag. I ain't going front. What?
You mean shoot to the subdiver?
What's wrong with team member? He back there making making all kind of hand movements. Do I want you to what? Shift the camera?
Yeah.
Yeah, you can show him the grocery. He's so helpful, y'all. See? All the groceries. So these are all our ingredients, as my son used to say, except for these marshmallows. Don't pay attention to marshmallows. But yes, these are all our ingredients. And yeah, I get the collard greens already chopped up and in the bag. Of course, we still gotta clean them, but they're fresh collard greens. So yeah, I'm not trying to impress nobody and act like I gotta chop them up and take them off the vine. Yeah, or wherever they are. I don't even know if they come on a vine. I think they grow on the ground. I don't know. But we gonna clean these ones in the bag. But we got our peppers, our celery, our smoked turkey neck. Let's see what else. Our chicken broth, our Creole seasoning. So we get ready to make this bay leaves, flour, you know, all the stuff. So we get ready to make this collard green gumbo. What I don't see though are my shrimp. Oh, Wallace already put them away for me. Okay, shrimp and a sausage. Okay, so we got shrimp, we got sausage. I have some Kaneka sausage that I bought last time I was in Mobile. So I'm going to thaw that out because it was so funny. I was just watching different YouTube videos to kind of get an idea of how I wanted to cook it, because y'all know I'm not a recipe person, and don't pay attention to my nails. That's none of your business. I'm not a recipe person, but I watched a few videos just to kind of get an idea of how I wanted to do this. And the one lady who was making it, she was like, and hopefully you can get your hands on some Kaneka sausage. She said, if not, I feel bad for you, but you can use andouille or some other smoked sausage. But I do have some Kaneka sausage because it is hard to find here. I have found it here, but the grocery store is a little ways away, and there's just no guarantee like that they'll always have it. So I still pick it up and bring it home every time we go to Mobile. So yeah, we're gonna use some Kaneka sausage, some shrimp, the turkey necks. I was gonna put shredded chicken in it, but I felt like that was gonna be too much, so I'm not doing the chicken. But yeah, so we get ready to get into this collard green gumbo stuff, and I know it's gonna be good, and I'm gonna make some cornbread. And y'all know how I make my cornbread, so it's gonna be good. All right, I'll be back. All right, y'all, we get ready to get started with this roux. So the first thing we gotta do, the pan is already a little bit preheated. I rinsed it, so that's just a little water, y'all, here. But we got a cup of all-purpose flour. and then a cup of vegetable oil. I already diced up and chopped up the vegetables, and our greens are over there soaking. And this is just regular vegetable oil. And then we have to start whisking it. So let me get my whisk out. I should have already had it out. Or we're gonna be burning already. Oh Lord, help me. Let's see. Alright, so we're gonna start whisking this. Can y'all see that? So it's supposed to go, let me turn on the stove light, to the different colors. So of course you're gonna start with a white roux, of course. But you want to mix it, make sure it's smooth. You don't want lumps. Whisk it, keep it moving so it doesn't burn. It will eventually start to bubble up, and then it's going to go through the different color changes as the flour starts to cook. So we want to go from this white light to like a chocolate color. And it should take a few moments, but it's already starting to bubble on the edges, so you gotta watch it. But I still got a little flour I can see in here. So make sure. Whisking, just like with the grits. Stirring and keeping your heat regulated is so important, because when this starts to bubble up, I'm gonna reduce my heat. Because I don't want it to cook too fast. So it's bubbling up, so I'm turning my heat down some. I want it to get darker, but of course I don't want it to burn. And that's what I love about a gas stove. In my opinion, you can just control the heat a little better, because with an electric stove, that plate, you know, underneath gets hot, and when you turn it down, it still takes a while, you know, for it to start to cool down. But with gas, you actually are turning down the flame. So just seems a little easier to control. But we want this to start getting darker till we get that nice desired chocolate color, that chocolate brown. And you don't want to burn it, because that smell ain't no joke, and it'll stay in your house. So yeah, roux ain't something you want to walk away from. Our roux is the like a caramel brown now. We've been cooking it for about 5 minutes or so. It's getting darker. It's not quite the chocolate brown we're looking for, but it's getting darker, and it's still smooth. It's not burning. Don't have that burnt smell, but you gotta keep it moving. Color will change, because you're definitely going by sight on this, just watching that color change. So you got to be patient, and then making sure you keep it moving so it doesn't burn, because you want it to cook and the color to start to change. But if it stays still, it'll start to burn. So keep it moving. All right, y'all see how dark that is? That's like your chocolate color, and it could be a little darker than this, but y'all see how slowly but surely, gotta be patient, stick to it, but you're gonna get that color change. And so now we can put in our chopped vegetables, which they call the Holy Trinity, the celery, the peppers, and the onions. So we'll get that in there, and be careful, because this is hot grease. So you want to be careful when you're putting your chopped vegetables in here that you don't splash it up on yourself. But yeah, that's a nice, pretty color. Like I said, it could get a little darker. Let me go grab those vegetables. Okay, so now our roux is the desired color, and we're going to add in our onions, celery, and peppers. Like I said, be careful, y'all, because this stuff will splash up. gently add these. And y'all know I'm not all picky and precise, so you do see some different shapes and sizes. I'm sure you saw when I was chopping it up. My knife skills don't always be knifing. But mix these in, control your heat, and immediately it starts to smell like somebody cooking. Immediately. Now this piece of onion is big as heck, so I'm gonna put that to the side. And now we are going to add our chicken broth. And I'm gonna do like 1.5 of these to start with. Just regular chicken broth. Mix that up a little bit. And I'll add a little bit more. It smells so good already. And I'm gonna turn my heat up just a little bit now because this chicken broth has cooled everything down. And that's Wallace fussing at Lux. Lux been acting up this morning, y'all. I don't know what's wrong with y'all nephew. But I'm gonna just add a little bit more. Maybe not even quite half. Because we can always add some more later. And then this is just some oregano leaves. I'm gonna add to that. And then some garlic powder. Add that. Then I have some basil. And some Creole seasoning. And then I'm gonna add a couple of bay leaves. So let me get my bay leaves together and I'll be back. All right, y'all, so now I'm just gonna add a couple of dried bay leaves. And then I have some smoked turkey necks, nice and clean. And I'm gonna put those in here and kind of just give it a little bit of a mix. That's a lot of turkey necks. Well, if it's too many, I'll just take them out before I put my greens in, but that'll be good. I only ended up cleaning one, let me grab a wooden spoon, one bag of the greens because I'm like, it's gonna be a lot. But yeah, so I've just put this all in here, give it a little stir. I'm gonna put the lid on and just let this kind of simmer all together for about 40 minutes. But look at that. And it smells like Thanksgiving in here. Thanksgiving is just a couple of weeks away. All right, I'm gonna put the lid on, clean up my mess, and I'll pick y'all up for the next step. Okay, so it's been about 40, 45 minutes. The house is smelling delightful. Looking good, smelling good. And now we are going to add our fresh collards. Because I don't know why you wouldn't consider these fresh just because they came in the bag, because they're still raw, not processed, not cooked. So these are still fresh collards, but I did not take them off the stem myself. And I'm just going to slowly and gently add these in. And stop every once in a while just to kind of press them down, because y'all know how these shrink up. So it seems like there's a lot, but not really. So I'm just going to press them down into the liquid. And then just keep adding. I thought maybe the turkey necks would be taking up too much space, but let's see. It doesn't seem like it. Because these, you know, like I said, shrink up so much. But I still think I'm only gonna need this one bag because it's just Wallace and I. and we'll probably eat on this for a couple of days, 2 days at the most, just because of the shrimp and everything. You don't want to, you can't keep it too long. Definitely gonna make this if we like it. I'm sure we will. It smells so good when Nunny Butters comes home for the holidays, because he loves turkey necks and stuff like that. Y'all know my Nunny Butters is an old soul. It looks so good, y'all. So I'm gonna just keep adding till I can't add no more, but I think I'm gonna be able to get everything in here. But this is only one bag, which is good. Add them, push down. And they have some stems in here chopped up, which I like the stems, some people don't. But I don't mind the difference in texture. That's good to me. And then we'll let this cook for about another, I don't know, 40, 45 minutes or so until I add the sausage and the shrimp. And the sausage, the kaneka, I'm gonna like pan sear that a little bit and get the little crispy burnt edges on it before I put it in here for that texture and flavor as well. I think when you pan sear it, it brings the oils and the flavors out a little bit better. Like, I don't just want boiled sausage. So, but yeah, I think that's all gonna fit, which is great. Your girl don't like to waste nothing. We ain't wasting. I don't like the way that leaf looks. Get that one out. How about we were watching, let me get on camera for a second. We were watching QVC. I can't remember what day, y'all know we old, but we were watching QVC one evening and they were doing the Mrs. Printable candy apples, which I love. They're like dipped in caramel, then dipped in chocolate, and then they'll have like peanut butter chips on them, or, you know, peanuts or whatever. But they were cutting them and she was talking about how fresh all of the apples are and how the apples that you ordered that night haven't even been picked yet. Like, that's how fresh they are. And y'all, why did she cut into the apple while she was talking? And, you know, because they do the demonstrations and pull them apart and show the thickness of the caramel. So she cut into the apple and y'all, there was a big brown spot in the middle of the apple. So she cut it and she saw it and then immediately put it back together and grabbed another apple. Of course, Wallace caught it because he is Mr. Attention to Detail. And so he rewound it. He was like, oh, shoot, babe, that apple was bad. Hilarious. Which, you know, when you're dealing with stuff like fresh fruits and vegetables, I mean, it happens, but it was just so funny because at the time she was just like, we only have the freshest of apples and we don't let them sit. We dip them, you know, pick them and dip them when they're ordered. So the apples that you're ordering tonight have not even been picked yet. And big old brown mark. Oh, that was hilarious. But she caught it. She caught it. I mean, not soon enough. I'm sure Wallace ain't the only person who saw it. But like me, I would have never even noticed it, I don't think. If he wouldn't have shown me. But yeah, it was like about this big brown mark on there. Hilarious. So funny. But that's live TV, right? But the apples, I have gotten them several times. And they last. When you get them, they last like a couple of weeks. I think that the caramel and everything they put on them, just me. And you keep them in the refrigerator. But I think that caramel and everything they dip them in kind of preserves it and keeps them sealed, because they do last a while. Even though I ended up throwing away a few a couple of years ago because I just kind of forgot about them and didn't give them away the way I should have, but they're really good. But anyway, let's see, all the greens are in here. I'm so excited, y'all. Let me show y'all what we're working with. Everything's in here nice and covered up. Clean up behind myself. I'm gonna put the lid on and then let this simmer, like I said, for, I don't know, 45 minutes to an hour, who knows. I'm gonna go upstairs and edit the video that's gonna come out for y'all today. So I'll let this simmer and just check on it. But it's in between medium and low heat. So, because nothing's really cooking, right? So even the raw vegetables, you can eat these collards raw and they wouldn't hurt you. So I'm really, this is just for the flavor and the texture. And Wallace does not like real crisp vegetables. He likes his a little mushy. So yeah, but anyway, I'm thinking about just making this maybe a cooking video and not so much a vlog. We'll see how much footage we have and then I can start vlogging tomorrow, because you know we got to make this content stretch so I can continue to give y'all quality video. So this might just be a cooking video. I'm glad too, because I look a mess. Y'all don't need to see me the whole time. But yeah, so I'm gonna let this simmer and go upstairs and finish editing, and I will pick y'all up when it is time for me to start browning this sausage. Okay, so we are getting ready to do this corn bread. So y'all know we starting with the Jiffy. Then we're gonna doctor it on up and get it in the oven, because these greens are just about done. And I'm gonna do two boxes of the Jiffy. So box number one. Is this the right thing? Okay. They just did the boxes, I mean the package a little different. Jiffy, that's fine. Better be the same thing. Box number two. Corn muffin mix. Corn muffin mix. Then we're going to add a little almond milk. And then some heavy whipping cream. Y'all know I love heavy whipping cream. And we may add some more depending on the texture. Then do our eggs. I got my sausages cut up over here, because we'll be browning those in a second. Bless you. Two eggs. I'm gonna rinse my fingers. I hate when I leave this pantry door open. I feel like this is a mess. And it's really not a mess. It's really neat. We just got a bunch of stuff. All right, and then I'm gonna do about a cap full of vanilla. A little cinnamon. A little allspice. A little brown sugar, babe. Mm-hmm. And that didn't fall in there. That was a piece of paper from the twist tab, and it did not fall in the cornbread. Flour. So just a nice little pinch of brown sugar. A drizzle of honey, honey. Time to buy some more honey. Not much.
Let me get my spoon. I love wooden spoons. Do y'all use wooden spoons?
I don't know what Lux is barking at. And then we're just gonna mix this all up until we got a nice thick batter. Like I said, it's in between like pancake and dough, I guess. And if I add anything else to it, it'll be heavy whipping cream, not the almond milk, because the almond milk is kind of thin, so. Just put a touch more heavy whipping cream. Just a little. Mix it up until it is nice and smooth. Then I'm gonna butter my dish and get this in the oven. All right, so I got it all mixed. Got our pan buttered, and then I'm gonna switch out my wooden spoon. Oops, I'm splashing everywhere. For my rubber spatula. because again, we ain't gonna be wasting. Make sure it's mixed good. Scrape them edges. You gotta take care of them edges. Get this in here. I really didn't need this big pan. My cornbread's gonna be a little thin, but that's okay. I don't know what made me grab this big casserole dish. This is usually when I make 3 boxes. And that's what I always made when all the cheering was home. But that's okay. It'll just be a little thin. It's still gonna taste the same. Actually, that's better. So I won't eat as much, I guess. I really need to scrape it too to fill this. Fill this. I didn't even think about it until I start putting it in here. I'm like, you know what? This ain't what I use when I only do 2 boxes. But that's fine. We're just gonna spread it out. Cover the whole thing. Cause I'm not gonna bother to dirty another dish. Get it even in here. Wallace gonna be like, what the heck? Got cornbread, pancakes. But see how I made that work? And it'll rise a little bit. But it's fine. It's fine. That's what my grandson says. I'm fine. I'm fine, baby. There we go. All right, I'm gonna throw this in the oven and I will pick y'all up when I brown the sausage. All right, y'all, we get ready to do this sausage because these are just about done. Cornbread is in the oven and it's rising nicely, so it'll be fine in that pan. So I'm just gonna put a little heat on this pan for a second, kind of let it warm up, grab my sausage. It's already chopped up, some good old Kaneka. And then I'm just gonna put a little olive oil in the bottom of the pan just so it, cause these are copper pans, but I don't know. They still feel like they stick sometimes. So, if y'all hear that in the back, my husband is listening to a sermon. Look at this. Can y'all see this? Y'all see that steam? It smells so good in here. I wish y'all could smell it. I'm so excited to try it. I love cooking new things. And this is something I have bought before from other people who make it, you know, like caterers or whatever, but I've never made it myself. It's always too salty when I get it from other people, so that's why I decided to make it myself. All right, hear that olive oil heating up, so I'm just gonna put the sausage in here. And just brown it some, that's all. And I already have my shrimp in the refrigerator. I just seasoned them with a little bit of Old Bay. Nothing special. And I'm just gonna get these browned. All right, once these get nice and brown, I'll pick y'all back up once we start throwing everything together. All right, y'all, so the sausage is done. This head is a mess. The silk press, yeah, is no longer silking or pressing. I get it done again, like, on the 22nd, but I gotta figure something out between now and then. I might have to just put a little heat on it. But anyway, y'all used to me. All right, we're gonna put the sausage in here. Nice and brown. I don't want to pour it in because I don't want to get all that oil in there. Nice and brown. Oops. All the oil's in that other corner. Look, look, but follow me and follow me. Put the oil down there. Get these out. Ooh. This stuff be hot.
fire, so I guess so. All right, got the oil. Turn off this flame. Make sure you always turn off your gas when you're not using it. Mix that in there. And then let me grab our shrimp. They're already in the refrigerator. Seasoned just with some Old Bay. And I did the smaller shrimp because, I don't know, Wallace isn't a huge shrimp fan, so I don't know. But yes, I am going to put them in raw. I'm just like you would if you were cooking a regular gumbo or seafood stew. So don't let that scare you. It will cook in the juices, and shrimp does not take long to cook. So they've just been sitting for a little while with the seasoning. And it's not cross-contamination or anything. It's all gonna cook in here. And I think I told y'all, yeah, it was just a little Old Bay on there. Mix those in. And once the shrimp is cooked, we'll be ready to eat. So let me know what y'all think in the comments about this little recipe. Is it pretty easy to follow? You think it's something that you might try? If you comment now, let me know how you think it might taste before we dig in. But yeah, I just want to make sure all the shrimp are nice and covered in the liquid so that they can cook from the heat of our broth or roux, whatever. Cover it up, turn it up just a smidge to between medium and low. And y'all know I'll pick you back up. Cornbread, I think, may be done. So let me check the center of the cornbread. Y'all know you check it by putting a wooden stick or a toothpick in there and see if, you know, it comes out with any batter right in the middle. All right, stick is clean, so cornbread is done. Turn the oven off. So we about to be eating, y'all, and it's only noon because I started it early this morning. The groceries were delivered at like 8:30, and so that's when we got started this morning because I didn't know how long it was going to take because there were a lot of steps. So I wanted to get started early because, you know, it's football games and all that. So, yeah, we're going to be eating early today because I'm not going to want to wait. So I'll probably just eat a little bit and just graze throughout the day because I really feel like this is going to be delightful. So I'll pick y'all back up when it's ready. Okay, so y'all know I be extra, so I slathered some butter on top of the cornbread, and as you can see, it's not even really thin, and then I put some of that Mike's Hot Honey on top because I've been addicted to that, and then let's see what's going on with our collards. I don't want to overcook the shrimp, so shrimp is looking good, sausage is looking good. Y'all getting all steamy. Look at that. Ugh. Turkey neck's looking good. So I'll have Wallace give y'all a review after we eat. But that looks good, y'all. Okay, so the cornbread looks good. The collards look good. Let's see what Wallace think.
That roux is delicious.
Oh, thank you, babe.
That is wonderful, but turkey neck is on point, too. Thank you, this is
delicious.
He ain't
really a turkey neck fan, y'all.
Mm-mm.
This is delicious. You grab a shrimp or some sausage.
Some sausage here.
Sorry, y'all, it's fogging up from the steam.
Those are cornbread. Delicious.
All right, y'all heard it from the man, Lux. Mm-hmm. Look, every time we sit down to eat, Lux act like he gotta go outside. He bringing his bell.
I always give away too much. It's like I've got no sense of touch. I'm always pouring out my heart. No, little by little here.